to one of these hats, right?
If Kirk can challenge you guys, I challenge
you guys right now to do the chicken dance.
We've actually done it a couple times this morning.
I broke into the lyrics.
But I didn't get to see it because I was stuck in that horrible haze traffic.
Yeah, it's pretty bad out there.
Well, I'm going to take my chicken hat off, and I'm going to put on the old warrior helmet. Careful, brother.
You're going to put that on?
Falls out. Really, there's not much of it. What is left, I want to keep. So.
I'm always glad when you come on Warrior Wednesday.
Oh, cool.
It's cool. It's a lot of fun.
It's getting a little tougher to do.
It's been a little painful, my friend. Yeah. This past weekend, they were not road warriors. They kind of more like roadkill.
I'll tell you, it was nice to get back to... what was Jack Murphy Stadium? I remember it as Jack Murphy. Mm-hmm. It's now Qualcomm. But it was a tough game against San Diego State. We're going to take a look at some of the highlights or lowlights in this case. Of course, Norm Chow getting back there. It was the last time we'll see San Diego State before they run off to the Big East, of all places, Mountain West. So this guy right here, Ryan Katz, he was 10 for 74, 3 rushing touchdowns, quarterback. I mean, he was just tearing us up. At first, I didn't think he was going to be as fleet of foot as the Nevada or the BYU quarterback, but he was able to also hand it off to this guy who really looked like a rugby scrum. This is Adam Muema.
And just kept going.
Yeah. He was 20 carries, 79 yards, and a touchdown. It was tough.
This is what worries me, is everyone has seemed to do pretty well running the football against us. That alarms me a little bit, because what's coming up this Saturday?
Yeah, you know what? Rushing the football against Hawaii has also, it's been tricky, because Hawaii has been riddled with injuries in their interior.
Right up
They're
the middle.
Using defensive ends that are 250. I mean, I'm a huge fan of Bo Yapp. I keep saying this.
Yeah.
And he's a true defensive end playing in the interior.
He's given his best shot, but it's
Can you talk about the weight difference of the guys that
I mean,
going against?
He's 255 pounds going against offensive linemen that are 300 pounds, 300 plus pounds.
Yeah. It's a difficult challenge.
He's stepped up to that challenge every week. He's just doing a fantastic job. This week, like you said, though, New Mexico brings in, Bob Davies brings in a New Mexico team who we're all used to from the old WAC, but they're a team that has had to kind of convert around the players they have. And he, of all people, playing against, he was a Notre Dame coach for a long time, playing against Army and Navy, he decided he's going to try the option offense. They throw the football a lot. There's Bob Davies.
So is it going to look like what we saw?
Not quite, because they do throw they throw the football a lot, but they are averaging 271 yards on the ground.
Wow.
That's eighth nationally. Wow. So it's going to be a tough road for Hawaii. But it's homecoming, and Hawaii has won its last 10 homecoming games.
I didn't know that.
And it's homecoming.
Well, let's hope that.
Can you talk about homecoming for the players on the field? How important it is to see that the crowd and the people in the stands.
Yeah, I'll say this every week. I mean, it's so important to see fans and hear the fans. And Aloha Stadium doesn't take a whole lot to get loud.
Nope.
And so, get 30, 40,000 people in, and there's going to be a ton of giveaways. There's going to be a Vegas trip. There's going to be stuff, pom-poms for the kids.
Yep.
If you can just get to the stadium. And I'll tell you what, not to plead, but it's so much different, and you know this.
Yeah.
Watching a football game in person is so much different, regardless of how your home team is doing.
Yeah.
And I think it really does help.
There's a neat thing that's going to be happening, and we're giving a giveaway this morning, right?
Yeah, we're going to do a giveaway again.
Okay.
But we're going to change it up a little bit.
Okay.
If you can tell us, and if you're watching Monday night's sportscast with Canole or Tuesday morning's show with these guys, you'll know that Hawaii, and can we pop that up? Hawaii's going to be wearing a really cool uniform for a really good cause. It's for the Wounded Warriors, and it's a uniform that they'll be wearing. And if you can tell us against who or what the date is this season that they'll be wearing this uniform, I got a $20 gift certificate to Starbucks for you.
Now, you were saying, too, we're one of the only... None of the colleges are doing this, right?
One other college will be doing it, Boston College. That's
amazing.
The only two colleges that will be doing it. I mean, it's kind of cool.
296-KHON. 296-KHON. If you know the date or if you can say the opponent they'll be playing against. All right. Our man, John Venere, he is the cover analyst. That's for ESPN 1420.
Hey, you see where Manolo is?
This week's game, 6 o'clock again.
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
It's been weird.
Okay. Our man Manolo has been scaring the daylights out of us today. He's over in Evie Lee. Good morning to you, Manolo.
What kind?